Hold up.
Hey, welcome back guys to my channel. In this video, I'm going to talk about what is ternary operator and when you can use ternary operator. So let's get started. Basically, ternary operator is a conditional operator. Ternary operator are a substitute for if else statement. So what is the meaning of ternary operator are a substitute for if else statement? So I'm going to write one code. Now I'm going to show you. So by the way, we use question mark for ternary operator. We use question mark for ternary operator that I'll show you when I'll write the code. So let's get started. Okay, let's go to Visual Studio. Open it. Visual Studio. Oh, sorry. Close this. Create a new project. Console app. Next. Give it a name as ternary operator tutorial and create it. So I'm going to write one code, simple code using if else statement. Int marks obtain is equal to 30. Int passing marks is equal to 35. Boolean variable is passed, and here if statement. If marks obtained is greater than or equal to passing marks, the statement will return is passed boolean variable true, else it will return false, and it will write to the console that student passed the exam and is passed. That's it. So very simple program. We are going to check whether the student passed the exam or not. So first, marks obtained, whatever the marks obtained by student, and passing marks for the exam is 35. Is passed is the boolean expression. So in if statement, it will check whether the marks obtained is greater than or equal to passing marks. If it is greater than passing marks, which is 30, greater than 35, it will return true, else it will return false. So in this scenario, it will return false because 30 is smaller than 35. So let's run this and let's check. So you can see this, it is returning false. Sorry. It is returning false. Okay. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to pass it here 50, and let's check again if it is returning true or false. It will return true now. So you can say this, it is returning true. So what if I'll say we don't need this much line of code, and we can write code just in one line. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to comment this much line of code Let's comment this and let's write here just in one line that is equal to passing marks, sorry, marks obtained greater than equal to passing marks. Now here we will, so this is the ternary operator which we will be which we are using, ternary operator question mark. It will return true, else false. So that's it. So it will show same output which we saw here. So I'm going to run this and let's check. So it is returning true, right? It is returning true. And if I'll pass it here 20, it should return false. So it is returning false, you can say this. So for better readability, we can use string if you want. String marks obtained, it will return passed the exam, and here it will return not passed. For better readability, you can use string. So I'm going to delete this line of code, and instead of hard coding this, what we can do is we can write is passed here, and let's run it and let's check. You can see this, it is returning not passed. Student not passed the exam. So instead of using true or false boolean, you can use string variable for better readability. Now let's check with another marks obtained. Okay, I'm going to type 60 and let's check it again. So you can see this, it is showing student passed the exam because 60 is greater than 35, which is the passing marks for exam. So that is it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you really did, please subscribe to my channel, and I'll be back with another video like this. Thank you.